Alright, hey guys, what's up? It's LuPo, and this is the tutorial I've been promising you guys how to reflash your Xbox after the newest dashboard update, what to do. I'll be covering a few drives in this, so pay attention, and I'll try to make this as easy to follow as possible. The things you will need are the latest iXtreme firmwares, the Lite Touch 1.9 has finally released, you'll need JungleFlasher 0.84 beta, you'll need an original firmware folder on your desktop and BenQ or whichever drive you're dumping your original firmware off of. And when you're flashing, I do recommend having a kit like this to power your drive, the CK3 Lite for powering and ejecting. And for the Hitachi, you can have Mode B. And if you're going to be flashing your Lite on for the fat Xbox, you're going to need a probe of some sort. And on top of that, you're going to need a free SATA cable and a SATA port. I wouldn't recommend using an Xbox to power your drive, only the CK3 power kit, but if you want to, you can, but it is not recommended. Okay, the first thing I'm going to start off with today is flashing your BenQ. Okay, first thing you want to do is hook it up, and after you do that, you're going to want to go to JungleFlasher and find the port on MTK Flash 32. You're going to find your IO port, and you'll find it, and you'll have your drive below here, and the type should be SATA. Once you've found your drive, you're going to first unlock your BenQ. Click BenQ Unlock. Once that's done, you're going to click Read. And what this does is it reads the drive's firmware that is currently on it and does a dump of it. Now, like I said, you're going to need a folder on your desktop to put your original firmware and store your keys and etc. and whatnot in it. Save. Now that you have your original firmware right there, you're going to want to load the iXtreme 1.9. So click Open Target Firmware. You're going to download the iXtreme latest version. You're going to find your drive name, BenQ, right here. You're going to go to Post 13141, which means after the dashboard update. Now, in the pre folder, we'll have Lite Touch Plus 1.1, and the post is going to be version 1.9. And you'll notice when you load it, your DVD key will be all F's, which are nulled. And you're going to need to click Spoof Source to Target. If you don't have that DVD drive key, you're going to ruin your drive and probably never get your drive key back. So it's very important we have that drive key spoofed. Once that's done, go to MTK Flash 32 and you're going to click Write. For BenQ, you click Write. You'll notice it erases your chips and it'll write the banks. It'll say Write Verified OK if you performed it correctly. And after that, you're going to click Outro ATA Reset, which resets your drive. And you'll notice your flash chip properties here go blank. Now the next drive I'm going to show you is how to flash your Lite On 9504 Slim drive. Now this is what the Slim 9504 drive will look like after you take it out of your Slim Xbox. The firmware version will read 9504, the hardware version A0A0, and model 16D4S. And again, for powering this drive, you're going to want to use a CK3 Lite kit, but you will not need a probe. All you need is a SATA port on your computer and the Lite kit. Now that you have your Slim drive hooked up, it's going to be the same kind of thing. I do recommend having an X360 USB Pro for this, as the read results are much better. And if you're going to be flashing your drive in general, having a CK3 Lite kit or CK3 power kit for your drive is recommended, because powering your drive from your Xbox is not recommended, and it can be detectable as your Xbox is trying to see a drive and it's logged and it's not a drive there, and it can flag and create a big mess. So having a power source other than an Xbox to power your drive is highly recommended. Okay, now if you're going to be doing your Lite On Slim drives, it's going to be a little different. You want to go to DVD key 32 and again find your IO port for your drive. And I've already done this, so it's going to already recognize my DVD key and call it verified. So once you're in here, you're going to want to go to Slim key. And if you're only trying to get your DVD key, then you do not need to unlock your Slim. But if you're going to be flashing and doing whatnot to it, then you're going to need to unlock. And this only applies to the 9504 firmware. If you have a 0272, 0255, or 0401, you're going to need an unlocking kit. And like I said earlier, it's going to dump your complete firmware off the current drive, and you're going to need that folder on your desktop. So original firmware here, it's going to dump your dummy, the serial, the key, and everything. It's going to create quite a few things. Okay, now that you have your key, it's going to be a little different this time. What you want to do is open up the JungleFlasher folder and go to firmware, and you'll notice the folder is blank. Now go into the latest iXtreme folder, and you're going to find your appropriate drive, Lite On Slim 9504. Right click, copy, paste the firmware right into there. It's essential that we have that in there. We have that in there. You're going to click spoof source to target again. Remember, we got to carry the original drive key over to the new drive key. So once you carry your drive key over and both of these match up, now the current 9504 firmware is only Light Touch plus 1.1, and Light Touch firmware right now is safe to use. You know, I've heard rumors around going that it's not safe to use, but Light Touch Plus is essentially safe, and the only reason 1.9 has come out is for the support of XGD3. Now, I'm not too certain if you play an XGD3 if it'll flag you, but if you do not have version 1.9, I would not recommend playing an XGD3 disc, and the current XGD3 discs out right now are only later copies of Halo Reach. So any Light Touch Plus firmware is essentially safe. So after you've got your keys and firmware loaded, you're going to go to MTK Flash 32. Again, find your I.O. port. Now, it's going to be a little different this time. You're going to click Slim Unlock, kind of like the BenQ Unlock. Now, because you've already read your firmware, you don't need to click Read. Just go straight to Write and make sure the Slim button is checked, or else you can run the risk of messing your drive up. And since it is a Lite On, you do have a chance of breaking it. So I would recommend that you take your time and see what you're doing. So click Write, and you'll notice it will erase your bank, and it will write. Now, like I said before, if you do not place that target firmware inside the JungleFlasher firmware folder, it's going to give you an error saying cannot find firmware. So it's essential you put it in there. It may take some time because these newer slim drives have a bigger bank and require some stuff, and JungleFlasher may not respond for a minute, so just give it a second and it will. So now that you flash your 9504 drive, and it'll say drive restore verified, okay, authorized, I'm just gonna click outro ATA reset, which again resets your drive. Now, because there are different versions of firmware drives inside of your Xbox 360 Slim, on the drive it may say firmware version 9504, but the Slim I have today, the drive, it says 9504 on it, but now that I click refresh drive, the actual firmware is 0401. Microsoft updated some of the 9504 drives to 0401 and 0272. So the only way to actually flash a 0401, and I had two slim drives. I had the 9504 with 9504 on it. That's what I used in this tutorial. But there are drives out there marked 9504, but when you go to hook them up, it's going to say on JungleFlasher, firmware version 0401 or 0255 or 0225. And what this means for you is the only way to obtain the drive key is through X360 USB, or to flash the drive, you're either going to have to buy a pro unlocking kit or the Easy Fit unlocking kit for $70. Now, the pro unlocking kit is $75, and the only way to get the key without putting the kit on is going to DVD key 32 and click Slim Key, and it will dump it through X360 USB. And since I don't have that, it's going to give me an error message. So 0401 and 0255, you're just going to have to get that drive unlocking kit and wait it out. However, flashing the 0401 and 0225 once you have the unlocking kit is exactly the same as 9504. Okay, now that you're on the computer JungleFlasher on DVD key 32, check your I.O. port, make sure your Lite On 16 GDS2 is selected, check your COM ports, and your Lite On drive should show up. Make sure everything is connected, because with this drive, reading and writing the firmware is a little risky and you can run the risk of getting bricked. Now click DVD key 32, and once you do that, you're going to take your probe on the main board of the drive. You're going to have to open it completely up. On the third hole to the left above the little switch, you're going to put the probe in it and click DVD key, hold it in there, and it'll say serial data is okay, and save it all. So it's the third hole to the left. Okay, now that you have your drive key dumped and saved, you want to open up the new Lite Touch Plus firmware and the stock firmware whatnot of your key and have it loaded there. Okay, now go to MTK Flash, make sure your Lite On selected. You want to make sure you have the power source available. Click Lite On Erase, click Yes, Yes. Now after the first message goes and the second one comes right there, make sure you power it off and power it right back on about a second later, otherwise you'll fail to enter it and you'll corrupt your drive. So once it has that second little message, turn it off, turn it right back on, and it should erase it. So now what you want to do is click the write button. It's going to write the new Lite Touch Plus 1.9 or 1.1 firmware, depending on when the new firmware comes out. It's going to write that new flash firmware onto your Lite On 7 series drive, and it should verify it, and it'll tell you that it is okay. And that is your drive being flashed, and once that's completed, click outro ATA reset, and your Lite On 7 series drive is flashed. Thank you to youtube.com/moddingtutorials for providing this footage courtesy of Modding Tutorials. So there you go, now you can flash your BenQ, your Lite On 7 series, your Lite On 9504, Lite On 0401, Lite On 0225 after the latest dashboard update. I know I'm missing the Hitachi series and the Samsung series, but in the description of this video, there are going to be links on how to flash those drives. All you have to do is use the firmware provided in this description, but those tutorials will work for those drives. I'm sorry I couldn't cover those drives, but I tried my best trying to cover most of them. Now, to answer back to some of the common questions of doing this to your Xbox's drive, now, what is flashing? If you come across this tutorial and you're still confused on what flashing an Xbox is, it is basically modifying your drive's firmware on your Xbox to play backup copies of a game, meaning DVD dual-layer media discs. Now, another question, obviously, is will I get banned from this? The real answer is no. No one's ever been banned for using Lite Touch Plus firmware or Lite Touch firmware. The only cases where people were banned were because they were playing games early, or they were playing a bad rip or a bad copy of a game. That is why it is essential to always patch and stealth your games properly in AVGX 360, and if you're not sure how to do that, in the description of this video, there is a tutorial. Now, if you're unsure how to open your Xbox, I have both a video tutorial for the fat Xboxes, which are the older ones, and I've just recently made a tutorial on how to open your slim Xbox. And on a side note, if you're going to be flashing your Xbox, please be sure you know what you're doing. And if you're going to flash it, you're going to need a 32-bit operating system. You cannot do this on a 64-bit. Well, you can, but it requires more stuff and it makes it more complicated. So just find a 32-bit computer. I'm sure one of your friends has one, someone you know might have one. They're common everywhere. Only the newer supercomputers are 64-bit. Now that you flash your Xbox, another question, will I get banned for playing modified ISOs or modified game content? And the real question is yes. Any form of modding has its risk of bans, but no one's been really banned for an ISO mod. It's only been because they've published videos on YouTube and then the Xbox Live enforcement team has seen it. Another question is, I flashed my drive, I turned my Xbox on, and I get E64 or E68. And the answer to that is, you flash your drive incorrectly. When your Xbox goes to boot up, it is not reading the firmware correctly and it's airing it out. So go and retry flashing it correctly with your drive keys. Another question is, how do I know if I'm flagged for a ban if I played XGD3 or AP2.5? Well, if you're running Lite Touch Plus 1.1 or 1.9 and you've played an improperly patched AP2.5 game, you should be fine. But if you're running Lite Touch stock or just normal Lite Touch
firmware, the risk of you being flagged for a ban is imminent and very high. And another question is, even though I'm running Light Touch Plus firmware and my Xbox is safe, can I play games early? The real answer is no. It is never recommended to play early copies. And another question is, can I play early releases of games offline? And no, because when you play that game offline, that activity is still logged on your Xbox, onto your Xbox's NAND, and once you sign into Xbox Live, that information is uploaded and they will see that you played that game before the verified date. And I do not recommend ever playing a game before launch because some of the game data cannot be verified and it may result into you getting banned. And for everybody doing this just so they can do ISO mods, I do recommend if you're going to do it, try doing it with friends, because if you bring it out to the public, people will report you and the Xbox Live administration and enforcement team will take a look at it and evaluate it, and in most cases will console ban you and or profile ban you. Another question is, now that I have it flashed, can I use regular DVDs to burn games? And the answer is no. The media must be DVD dual layer discs. And the top recommendation for discs I recommend are verbatim, which are very, very efficient. They're very accurate in burning. Next is Memorex, and then after that is TDK. You can use other dual layer discs, but the accuracy of burning decreases as the discs get cheaper. Remember, you get what you pay for. Now, in the future, Light Touch Plus firmware may be detectable, and what I'm stating right now, if everyone who's ever had it and has claimed to be banned from Light Touch, that is incorrect, but in the future, Light Touch firmware may be detectable. So in the future, this current firmware may get you banned, but at the time being, Light Touch has never resulted directly in anyone getting banned. Now, the current firmware I included in this tutorial is version 1.9 and version 1.1. All versions of Light Touch are safe, but I do recommend Light Touch Plus because it has protection for anti-piracy 2.5 measures. Another question is, I'm not going to flash my Xbox, I'm going to hot swap. Can they still tell I've launched a modified ISO? Answer is yes. Xbox Live does log in the data of the ISO or disk you've inserted into your Xbox, and if you are modding, they will catch on eventually, but no one's been directly result in a ban of an ISO mod. It's only been because people have reported you or an administration member was in a game with you, and that's why I recommend only doing it in a private match or offline with a friend through X-Link. Another question, what are the 0401 and 0225 or 0272 unlocking kits for the drives? And currently, right now, 0401 firmware drives, they are locked, meaning Microsoft purposely locked them for writing, meaning you cannot put modified firmware or any firmware on it. In fact, it comes with Microsoft stock firmware and that's it. The only way to write new firmware is purchasing an unlocking kit. Yes, it may be expensive, and yes, it may be a pain in the butt, but it is the only way to flash a slim 0401. And in all honesty, my recommendation is probably picking up a used arcade console or a used pro console off of Amazon and trying to find with like a BenQ drive and getting lucky there and flashing it from there. My recommendation is always to have one legitimate console and one flash, because once the flash one does get banned for some reason, you'll always have a setback on the stock console. And I hope this tutorial has helped you. I'd appreciate it if the video got a like or thumbs up. A subscription would be highly appreciated as it helps the channel grow, and expect more stuff.